Hi there, I'm Guthrie from Sharetribe, and in this video, we're learning about listing categories. In online marketplaces, categories separate different kinds of listings from each other. They help organize, or should I say, categorize, listings into clearly defined groups. Instead of scrolling through all the listings on your marketplace to find what they're looking for, users can instead select a category and browse a smaller selection of the most relevant options. Category structure on a marketplace can work something like this. A main category brings top-level separation between different kinds of listings. Under them, more specific subcategories help people narrow down their search. So let's learn how to choose which categories your marketplace will have and how you can create them in your Sharetribe marketplace. How to choose listing categories. When you're planning your categories, the most important thing is the user experience. The key is to create categories with clear boundaries to make choosing one easy. Imagine a marketplace for selling camping gear, and someone wants to sell their old tent. When creating the listing, the provider sees that the marketplace has categories for sleeping and tents, but a tent could belong in either category. Which one should they choose? On the flip side, consider someone who wants to buy a tent for their next camping trip. They visit the tents category, but do not find their dream tent because it was listed under sleeping. Instead of overlapping categories, the marketplace could have more precise categories such as tents, hammocks, sleeping bags, etc. Or have sleeping as a main category and all of the above as its subcategories. In a nutshell, clearly defined categories make it easier for providers to decide which category to choose and for customers to find what they're looking for. The number of categories also affects user experience. For example, if you only have 10 listings on your marketplace but 20 categories, your customers will find empty categories. And this in turn makes your marketplace seem emptier than it actually is. And if a seller wants to list an item, they may get frustrated scrolling through dozens of options to find the category that fits best. Try to find the right balance between specificity and enough options to guarantee your users a smooth experience with categories. And remember that adding, editing, and maybe even removing categories as you learn more about your users is a part of operating a marketplace. How to create listing categories. So, once you've settled on a number of useful categories, it's time to create them. This is how. In console, navigate to the listing settings and choose listing categories. Click add a new main category. Fill in the name and an ID. My example will be tents. In the beginning, I might just have main categories to not end up with empty categories. But as my marketplace grows and gets more listings, I'll add subcategories, maybe based on camping style. Click add a new subcategory and again, fill in a name and an ID. My tent subcategories could be backpacking tents, family tents, canopy tents, cabin tents, etc. In Sharetribe, you can have main categories and two levels of subcategories. And once all your categories are ready, save changes. How to limit custom listing fields to specific categories. Listings in different categories might need completely different information. For example, on our camping gear marketplace, tents and cooking equipment will need completely different listing fields. That's why you can limit listing fields to specific categories. You do this in your listing field settings. Open or create a new listing field and scroll down to category settings. Check the box limit this field to specific categories. Then click to add a category ID and copy and paste a category ID or IDs there. Now, this listing field is only available when someone chooses this category. Before anyone can use the categories to filter search results, you need to enable the category search filter. So once your categories are ready to go, navigate to your listing search settings. There, scroll down to category filter. Turn on the filter by ticking the box let users filter search results by category and save changes. Simple as that. How categories work for your users. Finally, let's take a look at how and where categories are shown to your users. In the listing creation flow, the provider chooses a category and potential subcategory right after choosing a listing type, if you have more than one of those. The details and listing fields they need to add next are determined based on the category choice. On the search page, customers can filter the results by category if you've enabled this option. Categories are always the first filter shown. Other filters that are based on listing fields come after them. That's it. Categories are a great tool for organizing your marketplace and helping your users find what they're looking for. So when deciding which categories to have, user experience is the most important thing to consider. I hope this video helps you get started with listing categories. And if you have any questions, you can reach out to us at hello@sharetribe.com.